Immediately, like the week after I graduated from college, I sent my resume to 17 Regent Street, and I had an interview the following week, and I was hired that month. And I hit the streets as a beat reporter.
Armed with an altimeter to measure altitude so I can check when I'm free falling and know when I'm supposed to pull the ripcord, I'm good to go. But notice how the color is starting to drain from my face?
Just like I'm falling for the first time.
It's now or never.
Never leave the station without some food, because you never knew where you want to get, you know, dispatched to, because you know you could be out, you could be home at the middle of the night and you'd get a phone call and your day would start. You'd be covering a fire, or you'd be at a press conference and you'd get a call saying there's an incident, there's a murder, there's something else, and you'd have to go out there. I even remember some people would say, I don't know how you do your job, because I'd afraid for go ask so and so this, or you know, afraid for like walk up to somebody and like put a mic in their face, or you know, I understand it can be intimidating, but I think we should never lose the sense that we have rights to ask questions and to get answers and to be informed and engaged and to participate in what's happening, because if you don't get those answers, that doesn't mean whatever is happening won't impact you. You really had to be very cautious about eyewitness accounts. I remember one story where we got sent out saying somebody had like fallen off a lamppost, and all the eyewitness accounts was that this man was a goner. His eyes were coming out, his bone was sticking out of his arms and all of this. And so we document these multiple eyewitness reports, and then we get to KHMH, and like as we're walking in, we almost kind of bump into somebody that was leaving. And so we asked the orderlies, like, you know, where's this guy that, you know, apparently is like at death's door because of this incident? And he's like, Siane? And he's the same guy that's walking out with maybe a scratch on him, you know? So it was always about taking everything with a grain of salt and questioning everything.
Today, Placentia is but a semblance of its former self. Hurricane Iris may have moved quickly over the peninsula, but the destruction she brought with her will be felt by many for a very long time.
I have to say, because of being a journalist, I have been to places and met people that I never would have met were it not for this job. I'm talking way back a bush, way out the key, you know, the smallest villages, the smallest communities, but that had the biggest stories. And I loved being able to be out there in the field and documenting it and seeing what life was like.
Getting to the mouth of the cave is no easy proposition. The journey begins 300 feet above the floor of this incredible sinkhole.
I really think the legacy of News 5 and the station is that they really brought to every Belizean that had access what was happening out there in Belize, whether it was droughts in Blue Creek or the water coming back at Five Blues Lake, or you know, some key that had been levied, or some, you know, island that had been sold, whatever it was, good, bad, ugly, and in between, they were telling the story. And it was objective reporting, and it was, you know, presenting what was out there so that you could then be informed and get to your own conclusion. And it's really, I think, the legacy, as I said, is that the people that have worked here and that continue to work here, I think are striving to keep up that reputation. And without question, some of my, like, ever best memories are at Channel 5, because of Channel 5, with the Channel 5 crew.